Hi, I'm Michelle Getzinger. I'm a realtor with Berkshire Hathaway in the Pittsburgh market. So we're about 2 or 3 weeks into this shutdown. There's a lot of unknowns out there. I'm sure you're feeling it too. I know I am. I'm a little bit lost of what to do. But I'm getting reoccurring questions from my clients, so buyers and sellers, about three general things that they keep, the same topic keeps coming up over and over again. The first topic is what can I do if I want to buy a house or I want to sell my house right now? Right now, you're not allowed to go and see houses. Real estate activity is not deemed essential by the governor. So we are completely not allowed to see any clients face to face. And that also goes for home inspectors, appraisers, and closing companies, okay? Now, there are some ways that you can skirt around some of the rules, but it's very, very small percentage of the ones that can get through at this point. So if you're interested in buying a house currently, the best you can do is make sure that you have all of your credit, your pre-approval, and everything in order. And you're just searching online. If you need to, go do drive-bys by the house. You know, don't be creepy about it. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, check out the area in the neighborhood. If you're a seller and your house is currently listed, things that you can do are some cleaning, some spring cleaning, put your decorations away, you know, get ready for when this does cut loose in a couple weeks. Definitely recommend a deep clean. If you have your kids at home, please try and get them to help you. Give them treats for cleaning the baseboard or scrubbing toilets. I don't know. You know, there's child labor laws too, so be careful. But that being said, that's pretty much where we're at right now. We're at a standstill. If you have a contract currently and you're under contract and you're in the middle of the transaction, there are certain guidelines to keep that ball moving forward. But I can list them below, but I'm sure whoever you're working with is coaching you through that at this point. But you can buy a house. Now, say you do want to go, you see a house that comes on the market and you're like, oh, dude, I'm so pumped. I gotta have it. I got my pre-approval and I'm still working. You can buy it sight unseen. There's an addendum that PAR, the Pennsylvania Association of Realtors, came up with that basically will lock you down in the house and it stays in limbo until the lockdown is over, and then the contract will start like it normally should with the home inspections, the appraisals, and then the closing. So there are ways to buy a house, but everything seems to be a little bit delayed. So I just wanted you to be prepared. So the second question that I'm getting a lot is, what's going to happen once the ban is lifted and we can go back out into society? Well, one of the things that I think is going to happen, there's going to be a huge demand for showings, and there's going to be a lot of, you know, pent-up demand in general. The buyers are probably making their lists right now. So sellers, you're going to need to be prepared for a huge influx of showings. Make sure that your house is in top order. Make sure, you know, you have all of your ducks in a row if you're a buyer. Make sure you have that pre-approval. Talk to your lender. There's going to be a lot of flurry here as soon as we're able to start going out and seeing houses again. So keep all that in mind. And we're also going to have to learn how to take precautions as well, because just because they've lifted the ban doesn't mean that the virus is completely gone. So I would recommend with my clients that we would go in with masks on and be careful that we're not spreading things in people's houses, and vice versa. You might want to take the same precautions when a showing is done for you to go in and clean everything up. So that's what I think you can anticipate happening once the ban is lifted, and hopefully we can get back to normal as soon as possible. And number three, finally, I think that this is the catalyst that is going to change the real estate industry forever. And what I mean by that is that this virus isn't necessarily just going to go away or disappear. There's going to be a lot of fluctuation with that as well. And that's why it's going to be very important that you position yourself to make sure that your pictures are geared towards virtual world where people can see them. And I also recommend 3D tours. Now, I'm not just talking any 3D tour where you take your iPhone and you stand in a circle and you spin around. No, I'm talking about for real technology like Matterport, where you can literally walk through the house, the always open house. So if we ever do have to go through quarantine again, or you're having an out-of-state buyer, or you really want to just start narrowing down the buyers, get that out there. It's so important. The technology is there. So you need to align yourself with professionals that have access to technology, who know how to use it, because we have now gone into the virtual world of real estate. And I think it's going to change not only in the real estate world, but I think title is going to change, the mortgage is going to change, everything is going to change because of this. And again, it was the catalyst. It did need to change, and now it is for sure going to be different forever. Thank you again for watching. This is Michelle Getzinger signing off, and I can't wait to see you again in person. Remember, we'll all get through this together. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like the content, and we'll see you again next time.